Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Lunar Eternal Blue Blind for Sega CD. I think we're onto something here. Fortunately, I can't tell you exactly how I got here because I've been wandering around. I'm kind of in the lower part of the dungeon and I'm on the right side. So I don't think I've been over here. And I just went through this hole and I saw a chest. Unopened on the other side, so this must be new territory. I'm thinking. I'm hoping anyway. So, unfortunately, in my travels, two of our heroes leveled up. One of them was hero. I mean, unfortunately, only in the fact that you didn't get to see him level up. So, hero is now level 15. And I'm not sure, it was either Jean or Lamina that leveled up as well. We can't spend any more points though. Okay. So check it out. There's something up there. Hope we get to fight this boss and that's the end of it. Behind a bunch of gelatin pawns. Oh no. Poe sword for this guy. Fire ring is very effective. Yes, gang up on hero. Oh, she can use fire ring. He's all the way over there. Unfortunately. Run forward, guy. Too late. Oh, she's using it on the gelatin thing. Okay. Bring it down. Okay, he's frozen. Have him top us off. Well, she's gonna knock him away from the gelatin thing. Oh well. A little stuttering with the music here. Just finish this gel off. I think the only one that's down is his hero. Oh yeah, and he's only 4 points down, he's fine. Check this out. An iron bracelet. Something we have already. Hold on. Can't equip. He's got an iron bracelet. Yeah, we bought them. Then I bought them for everybody. Well, I could wear them anyway. Okay, so we got one to sell. Ah. Round four, level 20. Ooh. We're okay, I think. Can't level anything up yet. Way. Can we go up this thing? No. Let's just top off just in case. Let me just check this. I'm not supposed to be here, but. In case some extremely important boss battle is coming. Let's just save here. Another. Ah. Oh! Look at this. Outside, saved. Monster? Big monster? I can't move.
It's an avalanche!
Yeah. Well, screaming like that sure helped. Lucia.
Hero, please open your eyes.
Lucia,
for me?
Stop leaving us like that. It's all your fault. Oh, Hero, I'm so happy you're awake again. Please be still. I must heal your wounds. What about the others? Well, thanks for that, too. I can't tell you how worried I was that you had both died. It was horrible. Ruby says, but Lucia, why don't you come back to find us? You risked your life. Your mission. I came because I love Hero. It makes no sense, but just before I came to you, I felt something was wrong. Not wrong in general, but wrong with Hero. It was very strange. When I was alone on the blue star, I never had such a strange feeling. It was like Hero and I were one. I've never felt that before. Well, whatever Hocus Pocus called you back to us, I'm grateful. If you hadn't come, we'd probably be popsicles by now. Come on, let's hurry and find the others. Alright, so it's the three of us. Ah, he's run far. Ugh. Man, do I have a king-size whopper of a headache. It's a good thing you guys found me when you did. Guess I'm luckier than I thought. Ruby says you got that right. Jean? What happened? The last thing I remember was Ruby screaming as the snow washed over us. I can't believe I'm still alive. Thank you. Anytime. Amina? Oh, poo! Look at my dress. It's absolutely soaked. Wait, there was an avalanche, wasn't there? How is it that I'm still alive? Ruby says it's because Lucia came back and saved our butts. Lucia says, I'm so glad we were able to find and revive all the party members. For a while there, I was frightened at what I might find. It's strange. I feel like my heart is relaxing. That's called relief. It's the opposite of anxiety, which you felt earlier. Relief. I like this feeling. Relief. Okay. Just saving in case we die horribly to this thing. Hello? Oh boy, the missing link. We shove a lot of fire up its wazoo. Oh no, it's magic. I am going to use the Sibilum sword this time. I'm going to preemptively cast health for everybody. He's going to go in the middle of the round somewhere. I don't know when this thing is going to attack. And even if it doesn't attack yet, we can still use a little top off. Right? Why not, right? Let's see if this does anything. And fire. Oh boy, see, that did nothing. That's not good. His Sibilum sword did nothing. That did something. Oh, it got rid of those ice things. At least he attacked two different people. Iron Tiger? Ooh, she just cast like some kind of, I don't know if that's defensive or offensive. Shot a Sibilum sword one more time. Might actually do something. Ronfar is going to be in healing mode for quite a while. And I think the flame is going to be the most effective spell. Nope, Lucia has a nice surprise for us. Topped off. It's a good thing. Not bad. 257. Oh boy. Won't you cast that thing on him again? Come on, Luce, should be useful. I'm gonna do Poe now. Okay. Poe does actually more damage. Gas blaster? Oh boy. You notice how she's casting it all on Hero. She like really loves him now. She's casting a lot of defensive spells. Trying to keep him alive. If you help us kill this thing, that's a great way of keeping us alive, thanks. Pole sword. Palm litany. Rinse repeat. Needle stop. Flame. As always, I hope Ronfar gets to go before the beast does. Cool. Ronfar is starting to fall behind, though, in points. It is easily more than 100 points more than the Siblum Sword. What did that do? Take away her mana? She really loves that guy now. Just have Ronfar heal himself. I'm not sure what his top level is. I mean, he might not need it, but so 51, almost 50, 49 points back. That was worth it. He's our healer, so we need him to stay alive. Boneyard? Oh boy. Oh my god, dropped bones on us. And froze two of us. Especially Hero Free. Okay, we need him to heal us up. Lamina is gonna go first. Let's unfreeze Hero. Thing. Sweet! That wasn't that bad. Bye-bye. Hooray! 4,000 XP received. Hero levels up again. Oh, he's catching up. I like it. I think he's starting to catch up. He's almost caught up to Jean. Except Jean just leveled up again. And Lamina leveled up. At least we're all awake for this. Ruby says, the beast must have caused the avalanche. Now that he's destroyed, the village should have much better luck with weather. Well, now what? Oh, definitely saving. You mean we're back to the beginning? I'm gonna cheat here. I don't know if there's anything else to be seen around here. And you can warp out of here, but there might be a reason. There might be a chest or something for us to find here. Forward to leaving these ice-based enemies behind. Be a nice thing. It's nice to have Lucia back, though. And even if we can't control her, it's nice to see the little things she puts in now and then. Even though she's just buffing up Hero endlessly. Lightning bomb? Oh, I spoke too soon. Awesome. Cool. That was pretty cool. Top off? Ah, we're good enough. Should we just warp out of here? Yeah, let's just warp out. I don't think there's anything new around here. Could be wrong, but I'm sure you guys will tell me if I am. Yeah. Off screen, I bought a bunch more of these things. Nice, we got a nice little theme back, different theme. Instead of just wind blowing. Now that the weather's more moderate and the beast is gone, the ski resort I want to create looks like a definite possibility. If this place does become a ski resort, I'm going to own all the cabins. But I haven't decided if I should rent them by the day or the hour. I guess it depends on what kind of crowd I want to attract. Yes, it does that. I think I saw fear in Lucia's eyes when she ran past me. Did you guys have a lover's quarrel? That always happens to people in love. You guys must be really, really, really be in love. She's with you, you know. She's right here. Ruby says, wipe that silly grin off your face. I'm telling Grandpa Gwyn. You need a good therapist to study your fear of commitment. At least, that's my opinion. What's in this way? I want to save because I don't want to get stuck in more battles. Oh, it's out the other side. This is not the way we came in. Okay. We can make the biggest man-made lake in history. I just haven't worked out what I'm going to do with all the dirt. I don't believe it. I can't believe you're back. I guess the old man was right. What? You defeated the beast? The only reason you defeated him was because I softened him up for you. Ruby says, oh yeah, he sure looked like he was on his deathbed. I don't know why everyone is thanking you. If it wasn't for me, you would have lost. Give it a rest, pal. I heard the beast tried to kill you in an avalanche. How'd you escape? Lucia helped us out of that little mess, and just in a nick of time. Lucia says, there wasn't any Nick present. What are you talking about? With all this cold weather, I don't think I'll ever get better. I really hate that monster. I like the period and then the exclamation marks after that. The mayor is going to have give me a reward for my heroism. You didn't do anything. I just don't know how I can ever repay you for all that you've done. My granddaughter and myself thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Lumina says, Mr. Mayor, I'm Lumina, the junior premier of the Magic Guild of Vane. I would like to present you with this bill for extermination services. Ruby says, Lumina, you can't charge these people for killing the monster. Pooh, where is that written in stone? I'm telling you that they will pay us a ton of silver for what we've done. Once again, I can't thank you enough for saving my village. Well, just remember that next time I'm going to charge you. Oh, the goddess has finally answered my prayers. My daughter's going to live. I just don't know how to thank you. Can I talk to her? My head doesn't feel so hot anymore. Thank you. Lumina says, you know, somehow that thank you makes it all worthwhile. Did she seriously just say that? It's very Lumina-like of her. Can you believe, like, I got stuck with this paper route? Half the people here don't have subscriptions to the paper, and the other half just don't care about the news. I'm starting to get feeling in my left cheek again. Thank you. I'm getting tired of that stupid girl running back and forth all the time. I've been trying to get to first base with that girl, but I can't. She says it's because I don't understand women. Ranfar says, don't worry, kid. There's not a man alive that does. I've been reading books about women. I think I'll finally get to date her. Books, huh? I should have put my shoes on before I came out this morning. At least then I could stop moving. If it's the last thing I do, I'm gonna make sure you stay awake. Only the weak and the stupid fall asleep. I can't believe you think only you can be the hero. Mommy, Johnny isn't playing fair. If we're going to play Donner Party, at least play right. Donner Party? Okay, I'm missing the reference on that one too. Oh, what's up here? What's the other side of that? Other level of this house? The mayor's upstairs with his grandchild. He's in much better spirits than she recovered. I don't want to go up there. Thank you for slaying the monster to free my girlfriend. When I grow up, I want to be just like you. Or Eddie Vedder. I haven't really decided yet. At least you're in the running. Don't do drugs like that guy. It's not the way, kiddo. I guess I have no choice but to make the best of living here. I promise to stick with him for better or worse. I guess this qualifies as worse. Jean says, look at it this way. At least you have someone to snuggle up with. You know, I was thinking about starting a snow cone stand. What do you think? I don't think anyone will buy it, to tell you the truth. What is that? I got a glimpse of something right before I walked out. Is that a picture of a poster of a girl? Looks like she's bathing in ketchup. I've had enough of this snow. I'm leaving to live in the desert. The ground will be so hot, I'll be jumping barefoot like a jumping jack. I'll be picking, peeling, burning, screaming, itching, feeling. Hot, hot, hot. Feeling hot, hot, hot. But at least there'll be no more of this damn snow. Some think that we're insane to go out in our skivvies and swim in the water. I think it's the only way to prove our superior manliness. I've repented of my wicked ways since it's become so warm here. Ruby says, warm? This place is like the inside of a freezer. Ronfar says, I don't understand why you're cold, Ruby. All that fur ought to keep you warm. I'm sorry, but this fur just doesn't cut it in these kind of places. Man, is it getting hot in this town or what? What are you talking about? This place is freezing. This isn't cold. I think I'm going to go put on my shorts. You stupid hicks deserve to live in an icebox. Well, that was pretty racist. Take a breath of that cool mountain air. That'll make you high on life. Yeah, after it freezes your lungs out. I don't know how to thank you for finally killing that icy beast. Now I can start to plan how I'm going to invest all of my money. You didn't by any chance scalp him or get anything from his cave, did you? What? You didn't get anything off him? Ruby says, oh, I'm so sorry. I was more concerned about saving this little ice hole. Ice hole. Great. You save us, but you don't bring back any souvenirs. What good is a dead monster if I don't have his head mounted on my wall? I just don't know how to thank you guys for defeating the monster. Ruby says, geez, it's still freezing here. I thought it would warm up once he was dead. Jean says, Ruby, you shouldn't be cold wrapped up in all that fur. That's what Ronfar said. Well, I don't believe it. You actually did something I told you. I'm actually quite proud of you, lad. Ronfar says, geez, don't go getting all emotional on me. I just hope you try to be nicer to me and my friends. Alright, we're done. Onward. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.